Hi, everybody. Welcome to Bulletproof Underwear, episode number 28. Whee! Yeah, this is a very extra super duper special episode of Bulletproof Underwear. Not only because it is the first one recorded in the year 2013, but because we have a super duper extra special guest. But first, I'm going to introduce myself. I am Yam Juice, your co-host.
I am your other co-host, Flex.
The Flexonator.
Yes.
And I'm WryBillyboy.
WryBillyboy! Woo!
And apparently I'm rather special.
That's right. So I don't know if people know this or not, but we've been trying to get you on the show for a long time.
Is it checking the post?
Were you just waiting to until you keep getting better looking? Is that the reason that you put us off so long?
I think so, yes.
I hope for that from me.
He just gets better looking every day, and finally he's good enough.
Really?
So
it's the easy life I lead.
Yeah. So what is going on in John? In case anybody watching this does not know by his accent, Billy Boy is an English chap, a young English lad.
I am indeed.
So what's going on in Yorkshire?
Well, right now, post Christmas and January, it's surprisingly warm.
Well, you look cozy.
By warm, I mean, be about 40 degrees.
Fahrenheit. Oh, that's warm. That's very warm.
Yeah.
So do you get snow where you're at?
Yeah, if we get a lot, it'll be probably towards the end of this month and into February.
Wow! So
I've heard it said that whatever weather the eastern seaboard of USA gets, we could get it about 3 weeks later.
3 weeks? That gives you time.
Yeah, it's a slow moving weather.
Gives you plenty of time. Prepare them.
So I just stay indoors when it's like that.
So people may be wondering, what are we doing with such a young fella on this show? It's like, don't we have an age requirement? You have to at least hit puberty.
Well, I lied about my age. I am over 21.
He can vote, and he can buy a bottle of whiskey and everything.
Yeah, I can, but I don't. That's another thing I don't do anymore.
You don't vote or drink whiskey?
I don't drink at all.
You're in good company here.
I just
like to be in control of the old breathing system. Keep that going.
So what'd you do for New Year's?
New Year, don't laugh. The wife and I went to bed about 10:30 in the evening, slept like babies.
And then you woke up to a nice new 2013.
Yeah, something like that, yeah. Just a normal day to us. We don't celebrate it. We had a very good Christmas, though.
All right, did you get a new bike or a new wagon?
Say again?
Did you get a shiny new bike?
I didn't. My grandson did. Beautiful little bike.
How many grandkids you got?
Two. One's 9, the boy, and the girl is 12. She was 12 on the 12th of the 12th, 2012.
She was 12 on 12-12-12?
All the 12s.
Wow.
you should have wrote that story into the news. They probably would have published it.
Everyone bought lottery tickets, but it came 12. Not good at all.
So have you ever won the lottery?
No, never.
I never won.
My wife has won a couple of times, £10 or something like that.
Well, I managed to get like three numbers. I should have got something for that.
Yeah.
No, I never play. We have a California lottery.
I just see the lottery as a paying tax.
Flex, do you have a Minnesota lottery?
What's that?
Do you have a Minnesota lottery?
Oh, yeah, we've got ball and an actual Minnesota lottery. So we got two choices to choose from the table.
We're getting a little bit of feedback from your computer there, Jeff. Can you turn your volume down just a tad bit?
Turn the volume down.
Can you, like, don't make it so you can't hear, but testing.
What you say? I can hear you.
All right, so this is a momentous occasion. Everybody's been wanting to get a chance to meet WryBillyboy. So what do you think?
Why?
Your face is going to be as famous as your words on the forum.
Really?
Well, don't worry. We have special effects that we can we can get rid of that that third eye.
Yeah, that's the final front eye. Oh, that was Frontier.
All right. So, what's everybody been playing lately?
Games. I've been playing a bit of Far Cry 3.
Really?
How are you liking that?
Sorry?
How are you liking Far Cry 3? Are you?
It seems a bit samey. It's a quest. Shoot this, kill that animal, skin this, craft that. And to be honest, I got a little bit bored with it.
Are you really? I haven't had enough time to play it to really form an opinion, but I like the graphics.
But Willie has been asking me to play Battlefield 3, and I'd given the game away completely. I've since got it back.
So you're going to give it a shot?
It's a hard drive, and then downloaded all the bits of extra stuff.
It's a long
download. Started playing that campaign so that I can get into it a little bit.
Yeah, that's all that stuff you got to download, man. It's a lot of stuff.
It's a big lot of information. Yeah.
Well, with the two discs, the memory it's taking up is about 18.9 gig.
That's hopefully you have a little bit of space left on your hard drive.
Yeah, there's about 20 gig left, but I can take things out.
Yeah. How old is your Xbox?
It's 120 gig.
Okay, cool. I was saying, how long have you had that Xbox?
I got that on my 65th birthday, which is, 4 years ago. The original Xbox... They bought me that for my 60th birthday. And along with that box came two free games. Lost Odyssey, which I've never played. And a strange game called Halo.
Oh, and I'm
completely new to this. So I put Halo in and played it. And I was absolutely amazed. And you'll know what the original Halo was like.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I just couldn't stop playing it. So I bought more Halos as they came out.
So you got into it when somebody else bought you the
Yeah.
Did you ask for your birthday to get an Xbox, or did somebody just have the idea, like, let's get him an Xbox?
I think somebody had the idea. For the second one, I just mentioned that I could do with an upgrade.
Well, see, if that day, that was a momentous occasion, if that day hadn't happened like that, so they got you some other present, who knows, right now, maybe instead of playing Xbox, you'd be, like, skateboarding or, bungee jumping or something right now.
Yeah. Amazing, isn't it?
So what was your favorite Halo?
My favorite game?
Your favorite Halo.
I think the second one, to me, was the best. Now, I haven't got Halo 4. You've got that, haven't you, Flex?
Yeah, actually, this morning was the first time I played it with... Me and Mystical played it this morning. And
you played online, yeah, right.
Yeah, and I actually got 2 kills my first match, so I felt pretty proud of that. Yeah, I am. I know.
Yeah, I have it too. I haven't cracked it open yet, but I got it for Christmas.
Well, I don't spend any more money just yet. The downloads for BF3, 4,000 points.
Mm-hmm.
That's some real money. Great. It's like, what's that, $50?
50 bucks. £34. Yeah, it's about $50, yeah.
Yeah, it's about 50.
Well, so that's some actual money.
So you don't just buy the game. You buy the game again, don't you?
That's it. You do. Yeah. You cheap Yorkie man.
That's me. Short arms, deep pockets.
Yeah, Flex is pretty cheap too. You know, when he opens up the wallet, the presidents are in there squinting, you know, because they haven't seen the light.
I blow in there and I get dust in my eye. Ow.
Yeah. Cool.
I got an 11-year-old girl, so she keeps me pretty busy with the wallet.
All right,
Just wait till she wants a car, man.
Shh.
No, don't say that.
11 years old. Is she 11 or is she 12 yet? I thought maybe
she's just short of 12. She's going to be 12 here in a month or two.
Wow. All right. So is she interested in boys yet?
Thank God, no.
It won't be long.
I know. She doesn't like Justin Bieber, though, so that's a plus.
She does not like Justin Bieber. No, see, I adore Justin Bieber. I have posters on all my walls. I have him on the number one on my iPod. Just kidding.
You love him.
No, okay. Speaking of pop stars. All right, so you're in the prime time. You would probably have been a person who would have been very influenced by the British, like the Beatles.
Oh, the Beatles. Yeah. They were in my era very much so.
Yeah, so were you like crazy in, you know, into the Beatles when they were out?
I wasn't crazy into them, but I enjoyed them very much.
How about the Rolling Stones? Were you a Beatles guy or a Rolling Stones guy?
Yeah, I was a Stones guy.
I knew it. I knew it. Can't very get no difficult. Satisfaction.
Yeah. Little Red Rooster.
Oh yeah. So I sort of think that you probably liked Brian Jones a lot.
Never heard of him. I like Queen.
Queen, yeah.
And Freddie Mercury, bless him.
Oh, they're awesome.
And on your side of the pond, I like Talking Heads.
Oh yeah.
I like Talking Heads.
That guy is crazy, man. He is nuts.
Yeah.
How about like hard rock kind of stuff? Are you into any of those guys?
No. Don't vote for that.
Wait a minute. I know. How about this? It's not unusual to be loved by anyone.
Oh, word, yeah.
Tom Jones.
Tom.
Oh, yeah.
He lives in Las Vegas, doesn't he?
Well, I think he's doing a show there and he lives there, but he's an English chap, right? Welsh. He's Welsh.
He's Welsh, yeah.
That's right. Well, that's the same thing as English, right? Isn't it?
Careful. It's British. But the Welsh are very proud people. They want their own identity.
Well, do they like... What's different about a Wales person and an England person?
A Welsh person is meaner than a Yorkshire person.
Is that possible?
Yeah. Only just.
Yorkshire person. Oh, my goodness. So, you know, when he came out with it, there's one Tom Jones song that I do like. Sex bomb, sex bomb.
Yeah.
You're a sex bomb.
I think he had trouble learning the words, didn't he? It's so complicated.
Yeah, he's pretty popular with the ladies. He's got a following.
Oh yes, he is.
Oh, yeah, he's got a serious following.
Well, I've heard tell that he's a man with enormous hands.
Does it, what does that mean then?
He's got big gigantic hands. And I think the ladies know what that means.
Right.
See how big my hand is?
Yeah, I see.
So are you right-handed or are you left-handed?
I'm right-handed.
There you go.
So am I.
Well, I use a mouse with my left hand.
Really?
Well, it's because the very first time I ever encountered a computer mouse was at my employer's office, and he was a left-handed eye doctor. And this is an old-fashioned computer with a yellow, monitor, and it wasn't even, it was really old. But that was a new computer at the time, and I had just had a DOS computer, a command line kind of thing. So the very first time I ever see a mouse, it's on the left-hand side, and that's how he used it, and that's how I used it.
Right.
And then that's what I got used to. So to this day, I use a mouse with my left hand.
Oh, I always use right hand.
Yeah.
You use right hand flex on your mouse?
I'm right-handed, yeah.
Yeah?
I can do it with my right hand, too, but...
Actually, that's an interesting story. My dad's left-handed. And they think I'm left-handed, but my mom taught me to do everything with my right hand.
Really?
They tend to do that. Yeah, in those days, they tend to try and force left-handed people to be right-handed.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's, I've heard of that happening before.
Right.
But you know that ruler.
The true test on what hand the person is this. When you go to the potty and it's time to finish up, which hand do you use?
I use paper.
always good. Now see, my mom grew up back in ye olden days. She's even older than yourself, Billy. My mom says that they had an outhouse and used corn cobs.
Corn cobs?
Corn cobs. They had plenty of corn cobs and that's what they used.
Ooh.
Just trying to imagine that. Be like a wire wolf. Oh my God.
Oh man! But then, of course, they would recycle it and make a pipe out of the corn cob.
Yeah.
Either that or the Montgomery Ward catalog. They would use that.
The monkey.
I know people around here in the day. They had outdoor looms like that with a wooden seat, big hole in it, known as thunder boxes.
That's a thunder box?
Thunder box. Probably because of the echo as things went,
Yeah. In this country, they call it a privy. It's a privy.
Yeah.
Or just an outhouse. Hang on just a second. And I'm actually recording.
I'm sorry.
So... Your voice is making it online here. It won't be the first time. she apologized.
I don't mind.
That's okay. If you have a chance to stop by, dip your face in and say hi to a distinguished gentleman and Billy Boy.
The both of us are here.
Yeah, Flex is getting kind of woolly. He's getting furry.
Yeah, I got to get it. Well, it's cold here in Minnesota right now. It's about 15 degrees Fahrenheit.
Wow.
So, and next week supposed to be down in the minus 20 range. Not Celsius, that's Fahrenheit. So, she's going to be a cold one.
Yeah.
You people are crazy. Yeah. You people who live in that kind of thing are nuts. I swear to God.
Yeah, we are.
Well, Billy, the people in Minnesota, they're all descended from people in Norway. That's why they chose that area, because it reminded them of home.
You betcha.
It reminds them of Norway, yeah.
Now, see, being a European guy, you've probably been to some foreign countries.
I have not. I have never left UK.
Really? You haven't gone to Spain for vacation or something like that?
No. I always used to go, well, the both of us, the wife and I, used to go southwest of England, Cornwall and Devon. Lovely part of the country. And if I tell you now that I've only ever flown once, took off in an aircraft, but didn't land in it. It was a sponsored parachute jump. And we all dived out.
You jumped out of a plane?
Yeah. It was great fun.
Oh, my God. And that's the only time you've flown?
It's the only time I've flown, yeah.
That's weird. You've made one takeoff, but zero landings.
Yeah, I never landed, no.
Well, I guess it's, fortunate that you're still here. You know, the parachute must have popped open.
It was, yeah.
Were you worried that the chute wasn't going to...
There were ex-American military parachutes, apparently.
Made in China.
They were okay. But before you got before we got certificates for the parachute jump, we had to repack the parachute. And I swear to God that I wouldn't wish anybody to open the one up that I'd packed and put it on.
Did you get to wear your own parachute or you didn't know?
No, all provided. But you just had to pack it when you'd finished to complete the course, and then you got your certificate.
Wow. So what made you do something like that? Whose crazy idea was that?
I have no idea. Club rules. It was over on the East Coast, near where Tatey lives.
Well, somebody forced you to do it? I mean, you must have said, okay, I'll
do
it.
No, it was a sponsored thing. I was raising money along with other guys for a particular cause, and we decided to do that.
Oh, my God.
It cost us £40 each for the course and to take the first jump. And after that, if you wanted to jump again, it was only about £10 to go.
Mm. So you think you might do it again?
I'm not allowed now.
You're not allowed?
When I did it, I was in my 39th year. And when you turn 40, they won't let you do it anymore unless you go strapped to another guy. You know, like you see these old ladies.
Oh, yeah.
Tandem jump.
That's the only way I'd be able to do it.
Well, you know,
die on the way down anyway.
Former President George Bush, the original, the father, I remember when he turned 80, he celebrated by jumping out of a plane. And yeah. I think it was a tandem jump, but still, for an 80-year-old guy, that was pretty good. And I think he did it again when he turned 85.
Yeah, he did it a couple times.
Yeah. Yeah, he just got out of the hospital, I think. He was
ailing.
He was ailing a little bit.
Yeah, I read that.
Now, I wish his son would have jumped out of a plane and never.
Yeah. Don't set me off. The IQ of a squirrel.
I know he possibly not the most inquisitive person who's ever been president.
No,
he was probably not very inquisitive at all.
He's getting the money, though.
He is getting the money. He's doing okay.
Yeah.
He's back on his ranch.
Now that he's retired, he's like not does anymore. He's doing all kinds of charity work, and believe it or not, he's like really big into charity, isn't
he? Good.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. Good that he's used. Something,
everybody's
something,
good at something, Flex.
Something good came out, but I guess.
Right. Well, whatever happened to Dick Cheney? Did he go back to the underworld where he comes from? No. I'm not going to say that kind of stuff because we have people leanings of all different directions here who watch our show.
Oh, yeah.
We're politically unbiased on Bulletproof Underwear.
Yeah.
We are
I'm not biased. I just hate all the politicians.
There you go.
Are you a person who writes letters to the editor and bitches and complains about politics?
No, it's a waste of time. It's a waste of time. The most recent thing that got my anger up a little bit was you know, that politicians claim expenses for everything that they possibly can.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the standard ones for them is to claim £400 a month for food. And they can claim that whether they're living at home or in a hotel in London by the House of Parliament.
That's a lot of food.
Yeah, it is.
That's a hell of a lot of food. You can eat a lot of oatmeal for £400.
Yeah. You got a second home provided. Oh, it's terrible.
Well, so you guys have a lot more entertaining politics than we do. I mean, you guys get on the floor of Parliament and they hoot and holler and shout and shove each other. And
oh, yeah.
They get crazy.
Yeah, across the house. The coalition is on one side and the opposition are on the other. You won't have seen this, but the carpet down the middle has a red line in it about 4 feet from the seats. And the idea is that it's more than a sword's length between the two, so they can't kill each other.
Keep them far enough apart so they don't...
Yeah.
Hey, speaking of swords, there's some game out I saw. I think it's a PC game. It's something about chivalry or something. It's basically Call of Duty with swords and bows and arrows and hammers and melee weapons. And you're a knight and you're running around on your team and you sword fight guys. And if you die, you respawn and you come back and sword fight guys. I've seen it on YouTube. It looks fun.
Might be. Yeah.
Interesting.
So you were around back there in the sword fighting days. So
I'll let the politicians get it. Anyway.
So right now
I've got my friend here. This is Eli, my friend.
Oh my goodness!
He's a bit worried about where I'm putting my hand. But I said you wouldn't be near him, so he's happy about that.
Hi, Eli. How's it going? Is he a Yorkshire man?
Yes, he is. He's got a flat cap.
He does. Do you wear a cap like that, too?
Like that?
Oh, my goodness. You do.
Oh, no. Look at this.
You know, I'm afraid to say that your elephant's trunk is kind of flaccid.
It is a bit, isn't it?
Look, it's drooping. You need to give him one of those blue pills. There you go. If your nose stays up for more than 4 hours, call your doctor.
That's right.
Little blue pills.
Little blue pills.
They were actually... I mean, they were trying to use those as performance-enhancing drugs because it gets your blood flow going. People were using it before they participated in sporting events.
For sporting events? So if you see a guy in his bicycle shorts and he's got kind of a little bit of a lump, you know, he's cheating. Oh goodness! So are you a person who follows sports? Because I know you British people are nuts about your football.
No, I don't like football. I used to support rugby a little bit, which is a bit like American football, isn't it?
Yeah, it seems like it. Except you don't wear helmets and stuff.
Except rugby, right. Sport, American football. Oh, I'm not gonna get started on that.
Well, there are people in the U.S. who play rugby. There's kind of leagues in all the major cities where regular people play. Well, I won't call them regular people. They're crazy maniacs.
Yeah.
We have leagues here in Minnesota. So.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't follow it now, but I used to follow my local team.
What about cricket?
I watch cricket on the TV quite often. No, and I can understand the rules.
I was about to say, does it actually make any sense? Is there any kind of rhyme or reason to it?
Of course it makes sense.
Sure doesn't look like it whenever you see him play.
They stop for lunch. They stop for tea. They play a little bit after tea. This can go on for 5 days. You get your money's worth, don't you?
See, but you guys have taught the rest of the world. I mean, they play cricket in India.
Yeah. They're very good, too, with the Indians.
I was surprised we were in the Bahamas. It was big there.
Yeah. Jamaica.
No, Australia. I just heard Australia. See, that's where you guys shipped all your criminals.
Apparently, right? Yes.
Isn't that the deal? It's like Australia is made up of the British criminals.
Originally.
A lot of Australians move back to England for some reason. I don't know what the attraction is, but
are they extra tough? Are they badass guys?
Oh, I don't think so. No. No, they just they like it here. That's the end of it.
I judge Australia by bite. Bake's a nice guy.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, he's spoken nice to bike for a long time, but he was cool.
Yeah. Yeah. So you're playing lots of Black Ops 2 these days, I imagine.
All right. The last time I played with Bike, it was I was in England, he was in Australia, couple of guys in America, and Kibbles in Alaska.
Wow.
And I was just sitting there thinking, what is this? It's just amazing. The distance is involved.
It is.
And Bike has two yellow bars and sometimes one red. And he's shooting everybody all the time.
He's good.
He's still kicking everybody's ass.
Yeah?
Yeah, I played weeks ago. I played Battlefield when he was playing. So.
Yeah, whenever U.S. and U.K. are playing together, you either have four bars or you have two yellow bars. It's like you can't have everybody have a good connection. Somebody's got to be.
If I play on a UK server, I can get four green bars. But if I play across the pond, I can live with two yellows. You just got to think a bit more about what you do.
But
recently I've been getting some good connections.
Did I see on the forum that they've started challenges on Black Ops 2 on the Elite?
Yeah. I put some details up today. There's one every day next week.
So this is the very first time.
They run for 23 hours.
So this is the first time they've started the challenges on there, right?
There was one on in the early days. No, two. There have been two.
Oh, okay.
Our first gold award in one of those.
Yeah. Now one thing I noticed is we don't have our gold clan tag on.
We should do because we're at level 10.
Right, but if you try to put your sub 1 clan tag, they won't let you use the dollar sign on Black Ops 2.
I've seen there isn't a dollar sign on the keypad. Yeah, I was looking at it the other day.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
You're probably right. We won't be able to get it, will we?
So we'll have to, if we want our gold clan tags to show, we have to pick a different set of symbols. Our four characters have to be different than no dollar signs.
It's not that important, really, is it?
I didn't know that.
Yeah. So when you're running your sub one, it's like if you're playing Modern Warfare 3, you got your gold clan tag, but you wouldn't have it on Black Ops 2.
Yeah. It's only this earlier this week when I tried to change it myself. And as you say, there's no dollar sign available.
Yeah, that's kind of weird. Yeah, so how do you like Black Ops 2? What's your review of it?
I like it, and I don't like it when I can't get a kill. And there's a lot of I won't say hackers, but their play is suspiciously fast.
Yeah, it's suspect.
Yeah. If you think about it, were you a good player or a medium player at Modern Warfare 3? Were you okay at Black Ops 1? Have you gone down the drainer in Black Ops 2? Then there's something wrong, isn't there?
So you're not doing as well in Black Ops 2 as you were doing in Modern Warfare 3?
No, it's more difficult. But again, earlier this week, played with Flex on Hardcore Kill Confirmed.
We switched to Hardcore.
That was better.
Yeah, I actually went positive, believe it or not, yeah.
Yeah,
cool. Now, I'm doing better on Black Ops 2. He's a hacker. Yeah, I'm doing better on Black Ops 2 than I was on Modern Warfare 3. I still love the original Black Ops, though. I'm gonna go back to that for a while sometime. You know, I can't ever resist the siren call.
I can't resist that game either. I love it.
That's still my all-time favorite game.
I did the campaign and everything.
Black Ops, the original.
The original Black Ops.
Yeah, it is good. It's very good. I shall certainly play some more Hardcore Kill Confirmed.
Yeah, that was a lot more fun than Core with the using two clips to kill a guy. And
you could get one-shot kills on this.
Well, yeah, the frustrating part about Core for me has been the guys that you shoot, you unload a clip in them, you know you got hit markers, and then they turn around and shoot you once, and you go down. That's what, to me, a suspect is. You know, it's like, no, my aim is poor, and everybody knows that, so... Having said that, as has been said by the clown so many times, if I learn how to aim, there's going to be a lot of dead mofos.
Yeah.
That's what he says all the time.
Halo jumpers are nice. It's good to kill them.
We got this league coming up. We're going to have a league, so hopefully there'll be some times that we do it that'll be good for the UK players.
Do you mean the official league or the one that we're talking about now?
Yeah. They're talking Twisted about league. The Twisted League.
Twisted.
Yeah. That should be fun.
Yeah, it'll be kind of cool. Mango is going to put up his crew, and he's smack-talking, thinks he's going to do really good.
Yeah, he'll do.
Hey, did you see the Bulletproof underwear where we had Mango on?
Oh, yeah. Sometimes I watch the video in two or three sections, and I watch this one all the way through in one go.
In one go.
Yeah.
You know what? I watch all the episodes too, and that's the way I watch them. Is I usually watch them, you know, in a couple of different sessions.
Mm-hmm.
And I might even be like on the computer, you know, looking at the forum or something, just sort of listening to it.
That's what I do. I listen to it.
Yeah, you can be doing something else on screen and listening.
Yeah, so it's kind of cool. We enjoy doing the show because we get to meet all kinds of people and people like your own self here.
Yeah, yeah.
Have you talked to anybody else on Skype besides me and Flex?
My grandson the other morning. He got a tablet. Downloaded Skype, or his dad downloaded Skype, and there it went, buzz.
It's pretty cool. It's like I remember, you know, they were talking about we're gonna have video telephones, you know, ages ago. They're talking about that, and we actually have it.
Yeah, it's amazing, isn't it?
It is.
I mean, look at this now, the distance between us.
I can still remember when, and I think we talked about this before, when you had to actually reserve phone time.
Yep.
You had to, you know, I worked at IBM for a while back in the 80s, and you had to reserve time to send faxes and things like that.
Well, there must be some sort of cables, like under on the ocean floor or something, you know, all the way across the Atlantic.
Yeah. Expensive calls, too.
Yeah, well, these are free. It doesn't cost a cent to do these Skype calls. That's pretty cool.
Is a group call free as well?
It is. No, you have to have Skype Premium to do a group call.
Ah, right.
And me and Flex, you know, had to do that. We had to bite the bullet.
Ah.
Yep.
But you can be in this in the group call with us because we have it.
Yeah.
But you know, this would be like this would be good for a guy who's got lots of girlfriends and he wants to talk to them all at the same time. Like if you have a hair.
Well, it's not my gun, is it?
Well, it's a lot for the morale of the troops. You know, I mean, they've been able to see their loved ones and stuff on.
That's right. Yeah.
Skype, so it's really helped those folks out a lot.
Yeah.
Now we're not saying that Skype does not have its problems. It certainly it gives us problems all the time. And in fact, I can't believe this call has gone this long without something popping up. You know, somebody dropping out of the call or something. So do you have a smartphone?
No, my phone is just a box standard LG slide bar.
Oh yeah.
And well, I use it more for texting than phoning.
Well, it looks like a smartphone. You can't watch videos on it and stuff like that.
It does various things, but it does what I want.
It does what you want. That's right. That's right.
Serves its purpose.
It does. Yeah.
Now I did try out Angry Birds last year, or maybe 2 years ago. Angry Birds on my phone.
Mm-hmm.
It's like if you're waiting for your appointment at the dentist office or something, you know, just pull it out and start.
Yeah, I get reminders of doctor's appointments, etc.
I'm getting my eyes examined today. I'm getting an eye exam at 4 o'clock and I'm going to get some new glasses.
Yep, I've just got some for computer use. These are varifocals that I've got on just now. And the computer ones are fixed to this distance.
Right, and you'll be able to see the whole entire screen clear all at the same time.
The eye doctor said, basically, if you've got bifocals, you can be doing that all the time with your head.
Right.
And it gives you headaches.
Well, that's what I do for a living.
Sold me a new pair of glasses, didn't he?
Yeah. That's what I do for a living. I'm an optician. I do glasses.
Yeah.
See, people always ask me, you know, you're an optician. Why do you wear old-fashioned glasses all the time? I just like them.
Yeah.
I could be wearing Gucci's or Giorgio Armani's or something like that, but I just like these old-fashioned kind of things.
Yeah, they look okay.
Where'd you go? I can't see a damn thing. Or, of course, you know. See, whenever you see me with these sunglasses on, I have them on over my regular glasses. Otherwise, I can't see the goddamn screen.
Okay, yeah.
I wear sunglasses because they're the only glasses I have that have anti-glare on them. And if I wear my regular glasses, the screen glares off of them like crazy.
These are my favorite bulletproof underwear glasses. That's the only time I wear these.
All right.
See?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Am I doing that?
I can see myself.
No.
Hold it up again. Hold it up again. I want to see if I got any spinach in my teeth. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Bit of spinach there, yeah. Bit of spinach.
Little broccoli or something there.
So what's on your agenda today later, Billy? I'm getting an eye exam. What are you doing?
Is it very expensive for the examination?
Oh, it costs about $70-$80, something like that.
Does it?
Yeah. Why, is it cheap where you live?
Well, when you get to a certain age, you get the basic eye test at no cost. But there's an added bit, whereas they do a scan of your eye and come up with a 3D image of what's going on in there.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
Yeah. Just a little bit extra that you either pay for or you don't have it. And I had that done. Before that, they just used to take a photograph of your retina. And it was about 9 years ago that my optician said, "You've got cataracts." So he found that I had cataracts.
Did you get them taken out?
Which I had sorted out not long after that.
Oh, okay. My mom had cataract surgery, and afterwards she didn't even need glasses except to read. She always had glasses before growing up, you know, as a her whole life, and then she gets cataract surgery, then she only needs them for reading.
Yeah. Now, at that time, I had medical insurance through my employer, and it cost about £6,000 to have them both done.
Ah, but you guys have health care. You have government health care.
Oh, yeah, but if sometimes your employer includes that in the package, then it takes you out of a queue, basically, and gets you better food.
So you're retired.
Yeah, I've been retired since I was 62.
So how do you like it? I think I would love being retired.
I love it. No problem, no responsibilities. I don't get about as much as I'd like to because I have a problem with breathing on occasion, so I just take it really easy. But I do enjoy my retirement.
Yeah, I can't wait. I'm probably not going to get much of a retirement. I'll work till I have to die. So what kind of work did you do when you were working?
Well, I started life as an electrician. Worked my way up, became an engineering supervisor and a manager. And I changed course a little bit and went into design, and that's where I had most of my pleasure in designing electrical installations.
All right, so you know all about electricity. We need to get our house rewired. We have an old house with like raw copper wire, and we got these little ceramic things keeping it from touching.
Oh, wow.
I think it's called knob and tube. Yeah, it's really, really old.
Yeah.
But the wires are thick. These thick, solid copper bars, basically, that are going through the house. And we don't have very many outlets. Each room has like two electrical outlets. You know, we have like extension cords all over the fucking place.
Yeah. Yeah, that's some interesting times in commercial buildings and hospitals, schools.
Wow.
Great fun.
So did you ever get your ass shocked really good?
Did I ever?
Did you ever get like a really good electrical shock?
Oh, I've had a few, yeah. Just make you jump a little bit.
Yeah.
I remember I used to do network administration and network installation, and I had a pager that was on vibrate, and I was working on an outlet, and the first time the pager went off on vibrate, I thought I was getting a shock. Something hit my head on the desk and everything. I jumped. The lady that was standing next to me, what happened? And I was like, I got a shock. Mm. And I realized it was the pager.
Then he realized the potential, and he moved the pager over to close to his front pocket and had his friends page him all the time.
Yeah, for reasons which we won't discuss just now. But we all know what they are, Flex.
Call me.
Flex, like this pager.
Yeah, please leave lots of messages. Yeah. So, Flex, what's going on over there?
Not much. We're just trying to stay warm today.
What are you going to do today?
I am going to take it easy, and probably then after that I'll probably take a nap, and then after that I'll probably relax, and then probably take it easy some more.
Wow, it's a grueling schedule.
Like that a lot.
Mode. I'm in the.
There's a clan up on right now, you know.
Is it right now?
Yeah.
Oh wow, we're missing out. It's like the three of us are here.
Still confirmed.
Is it core or hardcore? Is it core or hardcore?
Okay. It's core.
Core, okay.
Yeah.
Oh geez, all three of us are not playing it, so I guess they're probably
doing quite well.
yeah.
They're not hurting because of not being there. I'll tell you that.
So Flex has got Halo, and he started playing it. I've got Halo. I haven't started yet. Do you think there's any chance you might get Halo? The Halo 4.
I'll wait till you guys have finished it, then you can tell me what it's like.
Well, I still have to crack it open. I don't know. I've never played it before.
I like the graphics. I mean, it's nice.
Nice.
Right.
Right.
And the lobbies seem to work pretty good.
Do they?
You know, yeah, there's not a lot of, like, you know, in COD, we get a lot of, like, merging of lobbies, and you got to sit there and wait for it to count down all the time. Didn't experience that once in Halo. Every time the lobby just...
Oh, good. Good.
Wow. So were you playing with any other sub one people?
I was playing with Mystical.
Oh, yeah. Okay. How did he do? I bet he kicked ass, as usual.
Oh, yeah, he did. It was good to play with him because he was giving me tips the whole time. So
he's good. He's mystical.
Yeah, he is.
Well, you know, him and Tay-T, they just live down the road from you, right?
In effect, down the road, yeah, about 40, 50 miles away.
On the east. It was closer. I thought it was closer than that.
No, it's not closer than that.
Well, you guys should get together and like meet and hang out, and, like find a coffee shop, sort of halfway or something.
I don't think those two lads would want to hang out with a guy like me. Come with your granddad.
So what are they like, about 16 or maybe 17 or something?
I think
Mystical
17.
Mystical 17.
He's Mystical 17 as well, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, oh, yeah. God. Well, they're a lot smarter than I was when I was 16 and 17. God, I was a dumbass. I was a super dumbass.
Yeah, me too.
I was the epitome of a dumbass at that age. I was...
So, Billy, you were doing this. Were you a drinker in your younger days?
I like the beer, yeah. I like the beer. The beer and the cigs. And the women. And the rest of the money I just wasted.
That's it. That's it. Did you have like a pickup line that you always used to use?
No.
Let's see. I saw a couple of pickup lines on Twitter. Somebody posted. I forgot what they were. Do you do Twitter? Are you on Twitter?
No, I don't. I have an account, but I don't use it.
I don't use it as much as I used to.
Yeah. I prefer Facebook.
Yeah. You know, my mom is on Facebook. She's always trying to get me to get on it more. I have a Facebook, but I don't use it very much.
You don't. You're on Facebook.
How about you, Flex? Are you on Facebook a lot?
Oh, yeah. I'm a Facebooker.
So do you have embarrassing pictures of yourself?
I have pictures of myself when I weighed 400 pounds out there.
You're not nude, are you?
Huh?
They're none of them are from when you're nude, right?
Oh,
you're not naked.
No. Nothing. Come on. I don't want to totally embarrass myself.
Here's what you do. You go up to a guy and say, so do you have any naked pictures of your wife? And the guy will say, no. And say, would you like to buy some?
We first met on her 16th birthday, and I was 15 years and 1 week old. And her birthday is on Christmas Day. And that's when we first met, in 1958.
Wow.
And wow.
We're still having a go at each other.
How long before you asked her out for a date?
How long before?
After you met her, how long did it take before you asked her for a date? Right away?
More or less, yeah. Within weeks, yeah. We have our ups and downs, of course, but it's worked out pretty well.
Wow. So how many years have you been married? How many years have you been married? Yeah.
You're testing me now. We're 47 this time. 46,
wow.
47.
Wow.
That's great.
So in a couple of years, it'll be the big 5-0. You better buy her a really good present. Yeah. You have to get her a good present. Yeah, Anne is eavesdropping on this call, of course. So she says, what's the secret to a long marriage?
I think tolerance.
On her part or yours?
If I had to say one word, it would be tolerance. She tolerates me.
Yeah. So what does she think about you spending all this time playing video games?
I can't hear you.
So what does she think about all this time that you spend playing video games?
A diplomatic silence, I think. Because it's not as if I'm going out boozing or anything like that with the lads. She knows where I am. And she knows by 9 o'clock in the evening I will have finished. You ought to notice this, but if I start playing at 6 o'clock in the evening, by 9 o'clock I'm done. And that's it for the day.
Well, 3 hours is pretty good.
That's quite a long time, really.
It is.
You're lucky, Flex. You get to play during the daytime shift. I have to be at work. I don't get to play with the UK guys very much. Just on the weekends.
Well, it's Flex and Junior who pulled me across the Atlantic, if you like. And they would come on 10-ish in the morning, or a bit later for yourself, Flex.
Yeah, about
noon. That would be my evening. And we just used to play together regularly.
All three? You three guys would play almost every single day?
Regularly, yeah.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
Well, you still play just as much as I can during the day. Yeah. I've had some crazy stuff going on the last couple of months, but other than that, I try and get on at least once a day. And
yeah, it's good fun always.
We always try and have a good time with it.
Even the bad games are good fun.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. If you're playing with friends and you're having a good time, it's like if you're doing well, that's fine. If you're doing bad, you know, it's still fun.
That makes all the difference because you got someone to talk to about it.
Yeah, that's right.
Whereas I used to play randoms all the time and, you know, it's just kind of like you're there, but you're not there.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah. Is it?
The big sub one lobbies used to be great.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I can't see that happening anymore.
It's not as easy to do that. It's difficult to put together these big lobbies.
It is difficult, yeah.
On Black Ops 2, it doesn't function the same way as it did for us. And
you try and get in, and you just finish up down the road on your own.
Well, yeah, that's when we used to play the original Black Ops. We didn't used to have those kind of big lobbies, but we would sometimes get like a 6 or 9 people on the same team, and we'd be playing, you know, against randoms, but we'd all be on the same team. Those were great fun.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, a lot of times we'd get beat, but once in a while we'd have our day in the sun, and it would be epic. It'd be awesome.
Yeah, yeah, good times. Modern Warfare 3 was good for that.
Modern Warfare 3, it was really easy to get, you know, good lives.
Yeah, it was.
So, did you play Call of Duty before Black Ops? Did you play Modern Warfare 2?
I downloaded Warfare 2 to find... No, World at War I've downloaded to see what it's like. I think I've got 2 and 4. And then I started experimenting with going online with anybody.
So, Black Ops was your first Call of Duty.
Ops was my first venture into it seriously. Yeah.
Me too. Flex, you go back further than that though, right? You started with Modern Warfare 2.
Modern Warfare, the
Modern Warfare.
Yeah, 4 or whatever.
Well, I tried it later. You know, I got Modern Warfare and I got Modern Warfare 2 and World at War. I tried them all, but this is after no one's playing those games anymore. And in fact, World at War is so hacked, you can't even play that game.
Yeah, I heard that. Yeah,
you have people flying. People are actually flying
above the map,
under the map as well.
They're under the map. They're flying and they're invincible. You can shoot them all day long, and it doesn't hurt them at all. It's funny, you get hit markers every time, but they just don't die.
Nothing happens. Yeah.
Nothing happens.
Yeah.
Too bad, because it looks like World at War looks like a fun game.
You know what I like? Back then, I liked zombies. Like the zombies game back then.
You like the zombies on this latest one?
No, I don't care for it.
Have you tried it, Jeff?
Yeah, I played a little bit with the UK Yank Foxy Shooter and Dog Coffee Dog, whatever. And it was okay, but it was samey. You know, do this. That failed. Do the same again. And I didn't fall out with it, but I didn't fall in love with it either.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, so do you think that this is good training when the actual real life zombie apocalypse comes? You know, a lot of people are actually preparing for the actual zombie apocalypse. People think that's going to happen.
I can believe it. Yeah, I need a knife, don't I?
Money to be made, you know.
What you do is you build a fortress in your backyard and you stock it with lots of food and water and shotguns and sniper rifles and you make sure that you have really strong, you know, iron locks on your doors, because you know the zombies can.
Oh yeah, just that.
They can break through the walls, you know, if they get enough of them.
Build the wall back up.
Yeah, build the wall back up. Isn't it annoying where you have to build the wall? Like that you have to put
while you're building it, somebody comes around the back.
Yeah. That's kind of the most annoying part of zombies. It's like, okay, you got to go put the wood back up, build a barrier.
Yeah. I need the bathroom. I'll be 2 minutes.
Okay, I'll go get a drink.
Okay.
Okay.
We're going to take a break here, folks. We'll be right back. Yeah.
Yeah.
Three people unfriended me on Facebook, and I went into Facebook, and I can't even find the friends I have or who unfriended me. But the pop-up came when I was looking at Redondo Beach listings.
Okay.
So that might not be a true pop-up. If I was looking at Redondo Beach listings, I was not on Facebook, and it says three people unfriended me. And they're trying to get me to sign up for an app.
No. Don't sign up for any apps.
So that means nobody unfriended.
You know, I don't know. I don't really know anything about Facebook.
You know what? I can't maneuver Facebook. They changed it around. I don't think I was unfriended by anybody. I can't even find the friends I have on Facebook. They changed it so I can't maneuver.
Yeah, they change that stuff all the time.
But if I'm not on the Facebook and it says you've been unfriended and I'm on a Redondo Beach real estate app, I don't think that's true. They're just trying to get you an app. They're saying three people unfriended you and they're trying to get you to sign up for an unfriend app.
Yeah, don't do it.
I don't think I was unfriended by anybody.
No, don't believe it.
My feelings were so hurt.
Oh.
I just don't like Facebook. I'm never going to talk to anybody on Facebook anymore.
Well, you don't go on Facebook very often.
I just went on it today, and it used to pull up a picture of all your...
Who's doing all the shouting?
...and their pictures. It won't do that. It's all Secret Service stuff.
Yeah, I'm talking to
I'm just
going
to
Yeah, okay, so that's enough. We're about to get back on the show here. Our break is over. Anne was just griping that Facebook is giving her some problems here. She doesn't go on it very often. And we're back, ladies and gentlemen. We've got our very special, extra-duper special guest, WryBillyboy! Yee-hee! And of course you've got your asshole hosts Flex and Yam. You have to hold that closer to your mic so we can hear.
Was that the jibber jabber?
Quit your jibber jabber.
Yeah.
Mr. T. That's my Mr. T pocket.
Yeah. I want one of them.
So is Mr. T the father of that little, that funny little guy, E?
I don't know.
E.T.?
Mr. T's son is E.T.
That's right. You know, I've got a friend who comes over on Friday nights, and we always watch a movie. And, like, the last several weeks we've been into watching cheesy action movies. And last night we watched Dolph Lundgren.
Which one?
Oh, he was a sniper. And I can't remember the name of it, but we enjoy kind of these cheesy kind of movies. Really, really dumb action movies. Dolph Lundgren has been in a few. We were just watching Van Damme the week before that.
Oh, yeah. He used to do a lot of dumb action. Bloodsport.
Yeah. Now, the worst of all the dumb action movies was Steven Seagal movies. He is the worst actor ever. He's the guy with the ponytail like me.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
He's like he's on Prozac, delivering his lines.
Yeah. So,
what are you talking about?
So, Jeff, you ever go on Netflix? You watch Netflix?
No. No.
Do you have Netflix? Or do you have like a...
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you can get Netflix. Amazon. There's another one. Love.com.
Yeah, I've heard of that.
But I don't know where people find the time to watch all this sort of stuff. If I watch a couple of hours TV, I've had enough TV.
Yeah, I don't usually watch too much TV, but... I usually watch Netflix. When I do watch TV, it's usually Netflix. It's usually right here on my same monitor that I watch, you know, Call of Duty on.
Yeah. I record films off the TV, and I have quite a few DVDs. And that seems to work for me. And a PVR that has a delay on it and all that sort of stuff.
So is there any movies coming up that you're looking forward to?
I have no idea. I just don't know. Until about 5 minutes before when somebody tells me.
Now, there's one that's out right now that I want to see is Django Unchained.
Oh, that came out Christmas Day, right?
Yeah, it's a Quentin Tarantino movie.
Oh, with Jamie Foxx.
Right. Now, see, I watched the original Django. It's a spaghetti western from like the late 60s.
Yep.
And I've seen... Two remakes of Django. One was Japanese, and another one had Bruce Willis in it. They changed the settings, but it was basically the same story. So Django is a film that they keep remaking and remaking over and over again.
I had never heard of it before. Tarantino did it. I didn't know it. They'd even done.
Oh yeah, it's a classic. So watch the original one. The guy's dragging a Gatling gun.
So it's in a
coffin.
One of those spaghetti westerns.
Yeah, he's dragging a coffin behind him with a rope, and inside the coffin is a Gatling gun. It's kind of like the Death Machine. So what's your favorite kill streak, Billy? Do you like the Death Machine? Do you like Lightning Strike? What do you like?
I've never got as far as Lightning Strike.
Well, you can get them in a care package pretty easy.
High Plains Drifter got me onto a good one, which is the one where you throw an aeroplane. What's that called?
Oh, the Hunter Killer.
Hunter Killer. And then a care package. And what came after that? I forget what came after that now, but there was three. Oh.
Yeah, there was three of them.
Once you started getting them, they all came on quickly.
Because we were talking about it one day, because you can get them all three right one right after the other.
Yeah, they all really quickly.
Yeah, so I either don't get any kill streaks, or if I do, then they usually build up and I get them all. It's like it's all or nothing.
Yeah. Kill streak are like running out of ammunition. I never run out of ammunition because I die before I run out of ammunition.
See, I never have that. People are always saying, oh, I'm out of ammo, I got to find another gun. And it's like, I die so fast.
That's what happens to me.
I die so fast, I got all that ammo.
Okay, Anne is going to say hi.
Hi.
Hello, Anne. How are you?
This is Billy Boy.
Hi.
Hi.
Well, that was brief. So she got to meet TT and Jack, you know.
All right.
Several weeks ago.
International, you see.
That's right. So where's your missus right now?
Well, where I am now is where I do my gaming, and it used to be the smallest bedroom in the house, but now it's my cave. So I'm on the upper floor, and my missus is watching TV downstairs.
So you've got your man cave.
That's right, yeah. TV, Xbox, sound system.
Well, what you need is a pinball machine, a pool table.
That would be nice if I had a bigger room.
Did you ever play pinball back in the day, you know, where you got the little metal ball and the bumpers and everything?
What, in the arcades?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Because, you know,
nudge.
Before they had video game arcades, they had arcades that had actual pinball games.
All right.
I used to spend a lot of time when I was a kid at the arcade playing pinball and pool. Our arcade set, they had like a card room, pinball machines, and pool tables.
Really? Right.
Right. So you guys have snooker. You don't play pool. You have snooker.
Yeah, I used to play a little bit of snooker as a very young guy.
Now you play that on a pool table, but there's no holes in the table, right?
No, there are holes. It's a bigger table. It's a bigger table than a pool table. I would say at least twice as big.
Wow.
They're harder when the table's bigger. It's harder.
Well, I've never played pool, but I should think it's harder. Because pool, your angles of...
Yeah, your angles are a lot shorter in pool.
That's right, yeah. I'm just trying to think of the right word. Yeah. So you're either in or you're not.
See, that's kind of a status symbol if you're...
If you're miles away.
Back in the old days, it seemed like, you know, that was kind of the ultimate man cave kind of thing if you had a pool table.
Yeah, special room for it.
You have a special room, and maybe you even have a bar, you know, set up.
That would be nice.
That's a man cave.
Bar.
You had to have a bar.
If you had a pool table, you had to have the bar. I mean,
right, and above the table, you had to have a good, like a light, you know, like Budweiser or something like that.
Yeah.
Of course, you probably are a person who drank Guinness, right?
Yeah, occasionally, yeah. I used to drink Guinness particularly when I'd been to the blood donors, because they used to say, if you drink stout after donating blood, it's good for you. So I took that on board without any argument, you know.
Well, that kind of beer is so thick, it's like you're having the beverage and the meal all at the same time.
It is a bit, yeah.
Yeah, you don't have to eat.
It's like opening a loaf of bread.
Yeah.
It is, it's liquid bread.
Yeah, and then thick, later on in the evening, a black velvet. Guinness and champagne. Nice.
Yeah. So we eat a lot of pizza over here. Do you like pizza?
I like pizza.
Do you have it delivered?
Yeah. No. No, they're in the freezer. Get one out, shove it in the oven, and away you go.
We just discovered a new pizza delivery place. So over the last 3 nights in a row, we've had pizza delivered from Lane Splitter Pizza.
Oh, yeah.
It's very, very thin. It's the kind, like, you know, the New York... kind of pizza, very New York-y.
Thin crust, super big piece.
Real thin. I mean, super, super thin. I mean, it's like if you hold it, it is like lays straight down. It's so thin. It won't stick
out. I prefer the thin ones.
Yeah. So, Flex, you're up here close to Chicago. You probably like the deep dish thick pizza.
I actually lived in Chicago for 2 years. And yeah, I've had original Chicago deep dish pizza, yeah. It's a meal in itself to have one piece of that stuff. And it's good.
Oh, yeah. Well, see, I've never had a pizza I didn't like. I mean, seriously, even, even frozen. And there's one pizza I didn't like. I only had one. One birthday about 4 or 5 years ago, just as a hoot, just kind of a lark, we went to Chuck E. Cheese.
Oh.
just to play video games. And I was hoping to play that game, Whack-a-Mole, you know, where you're actually beating the little moles with a hammer. But they didn't have a Whack-a-Mole game.
Really?
Really, I was pissed off. That's why I went there. I want to play Whack-a-Mole.
See, Billy, Chuck E. Cheese is, I don't know if you got them over there. They're for little kids to go to for, like, birthdays and parties.
All right, yeah.
They have video games, kids' game, serve pizza, and
right, when you order a pizza, every single pizza comes with a certain number of video game tokens. So the food is absolutely an afterthought there. It's the worst pizza in the universe. It's horrible. But nobody cares because they're not there for the food. They're there to play the games. And it was noisy. It was so noisy. All these kids running around screaming and all the video games making all the noise.
Yeah. Yeah, we used to go with the grandchildren to, I'm just trying to think, was it Blue Budgie or Blue Parrot or something like that? Lots of kids' adventure things to play on at the same time, you know.
Right. They're diving into a big vat full of balls and stuff like that.
Yeah. Yeah. Pizza or something like that at the end of it all.
Right. Well, we did this. I think it was on my 51st birthday. It was just kind of a lark, you know, to be ironic. It was that kind of ironic.
You've got a birthday coming up, haven't you?
I do. 1 week from today.
Yeah.
I know. 1 week from tomorrow. 1 week from tomorrow, the 13th.
And it comes up.
You got any plans for that?
From Wednesday.
Ann was asking me about that. You know, let's see. It'll be on a Sunday.
We're going out to dinner Saturday.
So Ann wants to take me out to dinner on Saturday night. So I got to pick a restaurant.
Very nice.
So what's your favorite kind of restaurant? What kind of food do you like to go when you go out to eat? What do you like?
There's one recently opened in our village, and they do a fair Italian food. That's okay. I like that.
Italian food.
Yeah.
Do you have Mexican
food? Big Mac and a large fries.
McRib.
Oh, this morning for breakfast.
Yeah, I've had a McRib.
I had McDonald's.
Oh, what for breakfast?
Yeah, well, Ann said, I'm going to McDonald's. What would you like? And I said, bring me. I only ate two of them. Said, bring me some sausage McGriddles.
Good
so
great.
She brought me three of them. So I don't know if you've ever seen a sausage McGriddle. Do you have? You have McDonald's, right?
Let's have a look.
Of course you got McDonald's. Of course they have McDonald's everywhere. So if you ever wanted to see an American breakfast sandwich from McDonald's, here we go. See, this is a sausage McGriddle. It has a little McDonald's thing and a little miniature pancake.
You eat that?
Well, when they're hot, they're actually kind of good.
Yeah, right.
I'll wrap this up and we'll put it in the microwave later. It'll be delicious.
Yeah, I know, yeah.
This will be wonderful. So what about Mexican food? Do you have Mexican food?
I don't eat Mexican food, no. It's too hot for me. Indian food, having said that. They're not too hot. Curry. I like that.
Vindaloo sauce.
That's hot.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we have Indian food. We have a lot of people from India living here in the Bay Area. Uh-huh. They tend to be people who work in the technology industry, you know, like internet companies and computer companies.
Consulting.
Yeah, yeah. Bajul works in an IT thing, and a lot of the people in the office are Indian. And they're very, very smart people that she works with. Most of them are definitely younger. It's like if you're in the computer industry and you're over 30,
you're old.
You're kind of a rarity. Most of the computer people are young.
Do you like Chinese food?
I like Chinese food. I like Kung Pao chicken. Kung Pao.
Sweet and sour chicken's mine.
Yeah, I like that. That's cool.
Yeah, yeah. Sweet and sour is good. I like Mongolian chicken. It comes with it's spicy, or Mongolian beef. Yeah, Mongolian beef. It's spicy. It's got like a hot garlic sauce.
Yeah.
Getting hungry thinking about it. Except I'm full. I'm still full from those sandwiches. And she brought me McDonald's coffee, which I'm still nursing. I'll nuke that. I'll put that in the microwave later.
God. Haven't you got shares in McDonald's? Is that what it is?
Well, we're both kind of like people who don't like to cook very much. How about you? Are you a cook? Do you actually get in the kitchen and...
No. I warm things through.
I do like...
If it wasn't for the microwave, I wouldn't eat much.
Starve.
Mrs. does well at cooking. She's fine.
Well, see, that's the secret of a good marriage is have a wife that can cook.
Yeah.
I'm the chief cook in bottle.
Christmas week, I'm going up.
So, Flex, what's the specialty in the Flex household? What's your famous dish that you make the family?
My finest dish.
Yeah.
Hamburger helper.
Hamburger helper.
You betcha.
You betcha.
We got this box shit that comes like pasta sauces and stuff like that. You mix it with that pound of hamburger, and they call it hamburger helper. And my daughter loves it, so I make that. That's my specialty.
All right.
So I like mac and cheese. I like to make macaroni and cheese.
That's good stuff.
Of course, when I was in college, we used to eat ramen noodles because we were poor, and you could buy like 8 packets of ramen noodles for $1. And 1 packet of ramen noodles, you can make a meal off of that. So that would be like 8 meals for $1.
Wow.
And I used to eat oatmeal for dinner too because I was so poor.
Yeah. I eat that for breakfast.
Oatmeal's good for you.
Porridge. So, Jeff, what was my very first job ever? I worked as a busboy cleaning off tables in a steakhouse. What was your very, very first job you ever had?
Apprentice electrician.
No. Wow. So you didn't have one of those stupid you didn't have one of those stupid kind of teenager jobs.
Started that apprenticeship in January 1959, and then went to college on what we call day release, where you actually get paid to go to college.
That's a pretty sweet deal.
I just moved on that way. It was pretty good.
So, Flex, what was your very, very first paying job that you got?
I worked at a grain elevator, sacking up grain and loading up feed bins and stuff like that. My hometown is a small town of 26,000 people in farm country in southern Minnesota. So there was a lot of jobs on farms and stuff like that.
So you were sacking up grain.
Yep. Working in a grain elevator.
Yeah. Well, my first job was a busboy. Then I got another job as a dishwasher. And then I got a job working at Taco Bell. I worked at Taco Bell. I mentioned that the last episode.
I see a connection here. All food.
Well, see, those are the kind of jobs that teenagers commonly, you know, tend to get in the U.S. They're very low paying and they're easy jobs to get, and teenagers can get them. My first job, I was 15, and I lied that said I was 16.
Yeah.
The very first thing I ever bought with my first paycheck, I bought a watch.
You know, when I retired, I threw my watch away.
You're not wearing one right now?
No, I never wear a watch. Although, there's one in here, isn't there?
There is. There is. So Flex doesn't have to need for a watch. Check out my spiffy new watch band. I just got that last weekend.
Ooh. All right. That's okay. Yeah.
This is my trusty Timex. I've had this Timex now for about 8 years, and I've gone through about 4 or 5 watch bands. But the watch itself just keeps going and going.
Uh-huh.
Wow.
I think it was $29 for the whole watch when I bought it. Keeps really good time.
Yeah.
What time was it?
California Pacific time. It is 11:32. What time did the Glen Op start?
19:32
AM. 19? Are you on like a military time?
It's a 24-hour clock on this machine.
7:32.
So you do military time?
7:32, yeah.
Were you ever in the British military? Were you in the armed
forces? No, because I was too young. I missed it. We used to have a bit like your draft, was it?
Yeah.
Compulsory service. And it finished in 64, I think. And I missed it.
Yeah, I missed it too. I was only a couple of years. I wouldn't have wanted to be in the military. I did not. I had no desire to go in the military.
No. I spent a bit of time in the Army Cadets, but it's not the same. Not by any means. Carrying a gun through the streets. Oh, macho.
Now, in this country, everybody has guns. Flex has he's got a virtual arsenal. How many guns do you have? Just like 6, 7 guns?
Me?
Yeah.
Have you?
8 or 9.
He's got like 8 or 9 guns. Everything you can imagine, like pistols, shotguns, whatever you can think of. Flex has got guns.
I grew up in, Southern Minnesota. I did a lot of hunting when I was young, so. But as I've grown older, I've kind of gotten away from it.
Well, everybody knows that Americans love guns.
Yeah.
I myself only have a BB pistol. I just have a little fake BB pistol.
I have a 2-cell Maglite. That does my...
That'll crack.
Side of the bed. Bang.
Yeah, that'll crack somebody's skull.
So you're gonna hit them with your flashlight.
Yeah.
See, you are not ready for the zombie apocalypse. When the zombies come, you're going to be one of the first ones that they get.
I'll be the first meal, won't I?
You'll be the first meal.
Yeah.
No.
Here's my torch. Here's my torch.
You're whacking the zombie with your flashlight.
Yeah.
You guys call it a torch. I keep a little flashlight here. You have to have one close to your computer, because, you know, if I have to unplug a USB cable or something like that, you have to have a flashlight.
Why?
To see behind all that wire.
Oh,
all
that I stuff. Understand. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. So we have this game show, Smarty Pants, and... You know who does well on that game is older people. They know more things.
I've been watching that, yeah. I wouldn't mind having a go at that.
You might, kick some serious ass at that game.
Oh, I'm not saying that, but I can be as humiliated as anyone else.
Okay, right there, you heard it, folks. Billy is going to be on Bulletproof Underwear Smarty Pants.
Yeah, I don't mind.
Cool. So the current reigning champion is Dinjoga.
And he's a clever guy.
He's up there.
Yeah.
He's up there. So we'll put you down for a contestant.
Yeah.
And we just need to find one other guy and
And a civilized time to do the thing.
Well, we'll do it on a Saturday or a Sunday when we can do it like we're doing right now.
That would be nice for me. The other guys can do that, yeah.
Okay, yeah, Flex.
We do the other ones on Sunday or Saturday.
Yeah, get to work, boy. We need one more guest.
I'll get on that. Chop, chop.
See, that's what we have kind of a division of labor here. Flex is kind of the main guy in charge of lining up people and scheduling and getting folks on the show. It really does take both of us. You know, we do a lot to get these shows out there.
A lot of complicated operation from what I've seen.
Production work is Yam's specialty.
Well, here, this is episode 27. We've gone 27 episodes straight now, and we haven't missed a single Friday. They always come out Friday morning, and we do whatever we have to do to make it happen. So it's
even if it's just us.
Yeah, the last episode was just me and Flex.
No, actually, we're the first ones to see it over here.
That's right. That's right. Most people are still asleep.
What I've noticed is that if I watch it and then say, I'll put a comment up, mine tends to be the first comment after the...
Yeah, yeah. Actually, this last episode with just the two of us, Flex, I watched it again, and it's very funny.
I thought it was very funny.
There's stuff in there.
It wasn't that long. It's like 25 minutes. Did you watch it to the end? There's like some outtakes.
It's at the end.
At the very, very, very beginning of the show, I moved that to the end.
Yeah, I watched the end one.
So you know, I like to stick some sort of outtakes or something in there. It's kind of different.
Oh yeah.
So this will be a really fun episode. You know, when you see it, your name will be you know, it'll be moved. You know, you two guys will be scooted down to cover up your name, because right now you can see your names. I'll move that off screen so you can't see your names anymore, and then I'll move mine above that, and then we'll have, you know, everybody will be the same size, and we'll have our names on there, and it'll say Bulletproof Underwear, and of course,
dancing can go.
Oh, you know what we need? You know what we need? That reminds me, we need a promo from you.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. What can I say? All so, those of good taste, come on, look at this.
So, here's what you do. It's like, hi, you're watching Bulletproof Underwear episode 27 with 28. Is it? Yeah, it's going to be 28.
It's 28.
You sure?
I'm positive.
It is 28.
Yeah, it's 28. It'll be 28, yeah. So, yeah, you're watching Bulletproof Underwear episode number 28 with Yam and Flex or something like that, and it's like, and then just say anything you want.
Okay.
Whenever you're ready.
Hi there. Hi there, you're watching Bulletproof Underwear episode 28 with Yam Juice and Flex, and yours truly, WryBillyboy.
That's perfect. That's perfect.
Thank you.
Perfect. You have a face for radio.
Yeah.
So do I.
Just kidding. Yeah. Hey, have you ever been on television for any reason?
No.
I know, although, Flex, you've been on TV.
In this country, you can't go anywhere without being on somebody's television.
That's right. Big Brother is watching.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I've seen Flex on TV. One time, it's like the local news, you know, had me and Ann on as just like, you know, like we made some sort of little comment and we got to see it. It was kind of cool. And then one time there, I got to do a promo for some local show. I was sitting at a coffee shop outside, and there was this camera crew, and they were doing promos, and I said, "You're watching Streets of San Francisco with Michael Douglas and Carl Malden."
Carl Malden. I remember that show.
Yeah. We like old TV. We like old-fashioned TV shows.
Really?
Yeah, and last night she was watching Kojak.
Oh my word. With the lollipop.
Yeah, the lollipop guy, the bald dude.
Yeah.
Yep.
Kojak. Who loves you, baby?
I remember that show.
You know, now why on earth was that guy a sex symbol? I mean, the ladies.
No.
He's ugly. That dude is ugly.
He certainly was. And there's another one, Ironsides, the guy in the wheelchair. He had a heck of a following as well, didn't he?
Yeah. He used to be Perry Mason before
that's
that.
That's it, yeah. Yeah,
he played Perry Mason.
What was his name? Aaron Burr? No, that's not Aaron.
Raymond Burr.
Raymond Burr, yeah.
Aaron Burr was a...
Assassinated.
Aaron Burr...
John Wilkes Booth, didn't he?
No. Aaron Burr assassinated... Not assassinated. He was fought in a duel. He fought in a duel with Alexander Hamilton. Remember that?
Don't start the history on me, Tim.
See, that's the kind of thing you... That's the kind of thing that you'll be asked often on Smarty Pants.
Check that out of the Smarty Pants.
Yeah, we have to find some questions that are not U.S. history related, because it's kind of not fair. It's like asking questions about U.S. presidents and stuff like that if our guest is from the U.K. So we have to find other kinds of questions.
I'll take my chances. Whatever. Sports are a very weak subject for me. But the other week, I think it was Den Joga naming the presidents who were carved in the cliff face.
Yeah.
And I'm shouting at the screen, Washington! Sorry, Den Joga.
I've got a good friend who lives in South, who was born and raised in South Dakota, like right by that. And in fact, his town is a tourist town that people would stay in the hotels to go visit, you know, Mount Rushmore. Do you have any ambitions of having your own face carved into a mountain, Billy?
Ambitions?
Yeah. I can see you carved into a mountain.
Really?
Yeah.
No.
You could see it from space via use Google.
That's it. Crop circles. Hey, what about these crop circles? Are you behind that? Tell us right now. We need to know.
What about?
The crop circles. Are you responsible for the crop circles?
I can't discuss things like that. It's a secret. It's aliens.
That's in England, right? The crop circles are all... That's an English thing.
Crazy.
Some of them are pretty elaborate. Whoever the hell is doing it
are, yeah.
Very artistic.
If you see them, you just cannot work out how they do it.
I guess it's aliens. That's the only explanation, is aliens.
Aliens.
Crop circles. See, are we going to have a zombie apocalypse, or are the aliens going to come down and enslave us?
So this is
a question. I'm stealing this from Seinfeld. But, Billy, would you rather, when the aliens come, would you rather be in their circus or in their zoo?
Circus.
And why is that?
I don't know.
Well, see, if you're in the zoo, they're going to like make an artificial habitat, you know, and they'll have some humans like and the aliens will be looking at you through a glass, you know, you'll be doing your day-to-day life.
There may be, but the times that the wife and I have been to zoos, particularly with the orangutans, they are watching us. Not those watching them.
Yeah.
That's right. Well, they got to do something. They're like got nothing else to do.
Yeah, and break dance.
Fling poo.
Yeah.
So, but see, if they put you in the zoo, maybe you'll learn a new skill. You'll learn how to ride a unicycle and
useful, yeah. Something really useful. A unicycle on a tightrope.
Exactly. Exactly. Have you ever tried to ride a unicycle?
No.
Me neither.
I had a friend try until they put a saddle on top.
I had a friend who had a unicycle and he could ride it pretty well, and I tried it and I could not figure it out.
No,
could not figure it out. It's crazy.
Definitely art in it.
How about a horse? Have you ridden a horse?
No. You see, I've had a very boring life, really.
Well, you're a city boy, even though you live in you don't live in London or something. You're still a city boy.
A town, yeah, not a city.
Yeah, you're not a farm boy.
I used to do a little bit on a farm as a boy to help out. I used to make my holiday money in doing that.
Did you have a good Christmas?
Certainly did, yeah. Yeah, we went out for lunch on Christmas Day with the family. And the following day, we all went to the pantomime in town, which is something we really enjoy.
Yeah, so, you guys on the forum were talking about the panto.
Yeah.
Is that what you call it, a panto?
Yeah, yeah.
So what's the deal? What is that? What is that? Tell us about it.
Well, basically, it's a fairy story. But everybody dresses up crazy. The principal boy is actually a girl. and the dame is a man dressed up as a woman. You see where we're going here?
Yeah.
And there's lots of slapstick.
So reversal action there.
Yeah, an audience participation. It's great fun.
It does sound like fun. Have anything like that in the U.S.?
I don't think so.
I'm surprised that somebody hasn't tried to import that directly and just present it for the American audience.
Dan Joger, I think, was asking about it not long since. And I put a post up with a little piece of a pantomime in it. Look, it's Cinderella.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't see that. I should go back and look.
You get more idea if you look at that.
You better check it out.
Yeah. The one we went to see this Christmas was Beauty and the Beast, which I've never seen before, but it's a good story. And, of course, in the end, everybody lives happily ever after.
All good fairy tales, they have to live happily ever after.
They have to.
Yeah.
Well, see, not everybody lives happily ever after. Like Cinderella, the wicked stepsisters, you know, they don't live happily ever after.
Yeah, but Cinderella did with buttons. You see, you know the story.
Yeah, but don't you feel sorry for the wicked stepsisters? You know, they...
they ugly women. They're ugly.
Well, the moral of the story is if you're ugly, then you should just give it up because you have no right to be happy.
Yeah, see, the ugly sister, are two guys dressed as women.
So was Cinderella herself actually a girl or was it...
Yeah, she's usually quite... good looking.
Now, you know, the closest thing that we have to what you're describing is a Rocky Horror Picture Show. Is they have it all over the country. It's been going on for decades.
Yeah.
They'll play the movie, but here's the weird thing, is they have a stage set up. While the movie is showing, they'll have actors in costume doing the same thing that the people on the screen are doing. And the audience is reacting in certain ways. It's like certain scenes, they'll shout certain kinds of things.
Yeah.
And they'll throw things, you know, they'll throw toast or they'll throw rice or whatever the hell it is. And people will go back.
In a pantomime, it's expected that you will boo and hiss and cheer and sing. And shout, "He's behind you." If you don't do that, you're not taking part.
That's right. So did you do your duty? Were you hissing and booing?
I certainly did.
You better do your part or else.
It sounds like it's fun, like a great experience for everybody.
It's a good thing at Christmas, the day after Christmas. It's super.
So did you spend a lot of money on presents this year?
I've no idea. I don't count money. I just leave it whatever it is. It'll be what it'll be.
we did a lot of gift cards this year. In fact, I ended up, you know, I bought a whole bunch of gift cards. Thinking anybody I accidentally miss, I'm just going to give them a Target gift card.
Oh,
so
yeah.
At the end, I had a bunch of them left over. So check it out. These are all, these are all gift cards. So I could still give them to people for different holidays, or we could just go to Target and buy something.
Yeah. People ask, what would you like for Christmas or birthday? Because they're within a week of each other. And I just say, some sweets, chocolates, peppermint creams, Xbox points. They always get used.
Oh, yeah.
The thing is, if the wife and I need anything, we just go and get it. Never thinking about Christmas or anything like that.
That's right. Well, it's hard to buy presents for a full-grown adult, you know, because they have everything that they... If you want it, you go out and buy it.
Yeah, that's right. I think best thing for people like us is to just get some nonsense or a good book. I like a good book for Christmas.
All right. So do you actually read actual books, or do you have one of those electronic books?
No, I like the paper in my hand.
Yeah, I do too.
The smell of a book, it's unbeatable. Yeah.
That's right. Well, see, I know that those e-readers are having an effect on the industry. I wouldn't be surprised if 10 years from now, probably there's hardly any actual paper books.
Oh, no.
Oh, I think books will be around for a while.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, why have a store to sell books when you can just have a website? And you just click a button, and now you've got the book, and you can just read it anytime you want.
You can read it in bed.
No reason to actually go into books.
A lot of people still like to read. You know, they like Billy said, they like the physical, that the smell of the book, the feel.
Yeah, I like that.
Ah, you guys are dinosaurs. You're living in the Stone Age, man.
Well, that's right.
Yeah. I have a it's like, you know, somebody gave me a book for Christmas, and they're like, I already have a book.
Yeah. I read a book once.
Once.
Yeah. I have to say that I don't read too many books anymore. I used to be a pretty big reader, but not so much nowadays.
Yeah. I do most of my reading in bed.
Yeah. So do you think that society is getting dumber?
Say again?
Do you think society is getting dumber? We read less, we watch reality TV shows. I think it's rotting our brains.
I don't like reality shows. No. Society getting dumber? No, I don't think so.
You don't think society's getting dumber?
It shouldn't be, because if you think about it, if our children and our grandchildren and their children weren't better than us, we'd still be living in caves, would we not?
Well, you guys have got your man cave.
With a big stick.
We all three are in our man caves right now. So I don't know. I think if you watch, Anne likes a lot of these reality shows. It's like where they're trying to cook something, and they have to use certain ingredients, or there's some asshole guy screaming at them.
Oh, Gordon Ramsay show.
Yeah.
Oh, come on.
It's like, I wouldn't take that kind of abuse. It's like, you know, screw you. You know, you can't talk to me like that.
They'd be a slab, wouldn't they, by now?
It's
like, how dare you talk to me like that?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't need this.
I like the one where he comes up to the lady and talks to her, and she says, he asks her how the food is, and she says, well, it's pretty fucking good. She's like, well, that's how I expect. You'd expect me to talk.
Yeah.
And what about those dating shows? You know, where every week one contestant's gets eliminated until they finally, the Prince Charming finally meets up with his lady. Is like, Jesus Christ, that is so disgusting.
That sounds like a pantomime, doesn't it?
It does. Oh, the worst. The worst is the Real Housewives. Like the Real Housewives of New Jersey or the Real Housewives of whatever. These women are reprehensible. They're so uncivil, and they scream, and all they do is backstab each other.
Yeah.
And people love it.
Yeah.
Yeah, they like it, but
not it's like peering into somebody's life, isn't it?
I guess.
Just parking like, the curtains and peeping in.
We should have a reality show where a bunch of video game guys are all living in the same house. Don't you think that would be interesting?
I don't know if it'd be interesting. Oh no! Look, he's got carpal thumb today from playing too much game.
I've got a blister on my finger.
Thumb cramp. Game of thumb. Gamer thumb.
So Jeff, you ever gonna get a PlayStation?
I don't think so.
No.
I get enough fun on this.
But pretty soon, I think the next Call of Duty that comes out in 2014 will probably be on the new Xbox, whatever that is, the 720 or whatever it is.
I'll wait and see what that brings, see what happens.
Yeah, well, they're talking about the PlayStation 4 and the Xbox 720, the new consoles will probably be out next year.
Yeah, and what will we do when all games are downloaded and there's no second-hand market?
I guess you just have to download the games. If you want to play it, you just download it.
They'll have us right by the balls.
Yeah. Well, it probably pisses them off that GameStop makes all this money off of used games.
Yeah.
I don't know why they get pissed about it. It's like they charge $60 a pop up front for it, so they made their money. What's the problem?
Yeah.
They made $1 billion on the last Call of Duty in, 18 days?
$1 billion.
$1 billion.
Yeah.
That's for a video game.
The game is released, and wherever you go, there's stacks of them to be picked up. And then you find that the servers are not working, so they've done all the selling work, but the servers are not into it yet.
Right. Well, when the game first came out, the PlayStation could hardly even play. It was like glitching, and the screen would freeze, and you'd get kicked out.
Hang your X or your PS3.
It was it was pretty bad. It was kind of messed up on Xbox 2 a little bit, but PlayStation was really not functioning very well. After a week or so, I guess they kind of got it sorted out.
But, it took them a couple of weeks and they got it straightened out. But
right, chaps, can we?
We're ready to go.
All right, so here's the thing. So it's just about that time of the show. So thank you, audience, if you've been watching up to this point.
Yeah, thank you.
Episode 28.
Yep.
We're here with our very super extra special British young lad, WryBillyboy. And, of course, I'm your co-host, as always, Yam Juice.
Nam the Flexinator.
So you know what that means? You know what that means?
It means...
All right.
That's a good one. That's a good one.
Now, what about the outtakes?
The outtakes. All right, so where's that funny hat? Where's that hat?
What about that one?
There you go.
There you go. Man, you look dashing.
I don't know what I did with my hat. Here's my hat.
You still have the tag on your hat. What the hell is up with that?
It's Paige's hat. I couldn't take it off because she wouldn't let me.
Oh, look, I've got a ball on my chin.
Yeah, right. But they're not having them in the back of your throat.